9, verse 1, to chapter 11, verse 47. Leviticus is the third of the five books of the Torah. Today I will be reading from chapter 10, verse 1, to chapter 10, verse 11. In my overall Torah portion, Moses instructs Aaron and his sons to bring special sin offerings to the tabernacle. Later, Nadab and Abihu, Aaron's eldest sons, bring fire offerings to God, and they are punished with death. At the end, God tells Aaron and Moses what foods are permitted to be eaten and which foods are forbidden by the people of Israel. These become our kosher dietary laws. In the verses I am reading, Nadab and Abihu bring their own fire pans, but they offer alien fire to God, and the Eternal kills them with fire. Moses explains their deaths by saying, "This is what the Eternal meant by saying, 'Through those near me I show myself holy, and gain glory before the people.'" Aaron is completely silent in response.
For the honor of the first Aliyah, we call cousins Laura and Stephen Cohen and Daniel Cohen, Karen and Stephen Farber, Alyssa and Brett, Ya'amdu Bishonim.
And the Torah reading can be found in the insert in your prayer books or in the cloud commentary in the blue book.
Does anyone have a page number in this Torah commentary? Say it again. 801 in the Torah commentary, which is the blue plowed Torah commentary. It is not the prayer book. Okay.
Thank you. Amen.
was teaching earlier this morning that there's an idea that when the Torah is out of the Ark, it's like a more special moment in time. Something magical happens. Somehow maybe God hears a little bit more of our prayers. So we take a moment to really think of all those people who really need our prayers in life. Those who are healing either of the body or of the spirit, and who we're really hoping for refuah shlema, a complete and utter healing. So if there are those this morning that you're thinking of, please.
This morning's Haftarah comes from the book of 2 Samuel, chapter 6, verse 1 through chapter 7, verse 17. Today I will be reading from chapter 6, verse 1 to chapter 6, verse 5. Samuel was an early prophet and one of the last chieftains. During my Haftarah, King David is ruling and he is taking the Holy Ark to Jerusalem. During the trip, Uzzah touches the Ark and is killed by God. This scares David, but he still takes the Ark to Jerusalem. The Torah and Haftarah have a connection because in each one, a person or people die. In my Torah portion, Nadab and Abihu die after they bring in alien fire. In my Haftarah, Uzzah dies when he touches the Ark to keep it from falling.
The text can be found in the Torah commentary, again on page 986, or in your insert in your Shabbat program.
Oh.
I asked your dad this not too long ago, after another adventure into the city to meet with Cantor Bear. Who came up with this idea? Who led us down this path? A path which connects and enriches our family in ways we never could have imagined. Your journey grounds and aligns us as a family every day. Grounds us in a core belief and philosophy on how to respect, love, and live our lives within the home and community. We are a family celebrating on so many levels today. You have always walked with curiosity, intention, and celebration. You have always set goals, and you are always aware.